Previously on One Life to Live.
We have the alone.
Dorian! Well, fine! Run around out there and get yourself caught!
You can't run and you can't hide. I know exactly what you've done.
So you're obviously happy.
Yes.
And officially pregnant?
Oh my God.
What?
They followed us. What?
Who?
Christian, she's pregnant.
Just don't! No!
The crickets, the wind, my heart. They are all doing the singing. All for you.
Oh, Rod, what am I gonna do with you?
Marry me.
I will. Someday, I promise.
No.
No, not now. When you've done the work. When you've integrated all the altars into one man, someone who's really ready to be a husband to me.
I am that man.
Yes, but Tom isn't. And all of the others aren't. I want the whole man. I want all of you, not fractured parts. And I'm willing to wait a month, a year, however long it takes. Excuse me. I'm gonna go freshen up.
Are you crazy, Dorian? Showing your face in Lambview? The police were still looking for you.
You didn't think I was going to miss my daughter's wedding, did you?
Hey, just because you're marrying...
Don't these, Arlette.
I mean, you get out of a bachelor
party. Oh, no, gentlemen, no, not in the kitchen. We have a lot of work to do.
Sorry, Carlotta.
Yeah, the women folk have taken over all the other rooms in the house.
We don't want to get too rowdy, though, because the police are surrounding this place. They think Dorian's going to show up.
You know what? I kind of wish he would. It's been way too long since I've seen that gorgeous face of hers.
You know, Arlette, why don't we just serve these right now? We know when we're not wanted.
Oh, oui, madame.
Excuse us.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd like to prepare a toast to Kevin.
All right.
Makes me awful proud to be a father. And to new beginnings.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Well, Vicky was right. You are glowing.
I feel like my whole body is positively humming.
It's true, then?
Yes, I'm officially pregnant.
Well, I'm very happy for you.
Thank you, Sam.
You know, I always wondered whether or not you and I would have a wedding like this and...
A child?
Yeah. But we don't. And we won't.
And we never will.
Don't get any ideas, Lindsay. Where are the boys?
The boys are roasting Kevin in the kitchen. No ladies allowed.
Right. Everything is a competition
no,
with you.
It is
yes, it
not.
Is.
No, it's
yes,
not.
It
no, it isn't.
Real class player.
You know what, Kelly? You think it's funny? If you want food, why don't you go back into the kitchen? Because I'm sure Carlotta has a lot of finger food for you. Just go eat it there.
You know what?
What? This is not about food, okay? Cassie invited Barbara. She let bygones be bygones. Why can't we do that?
Because I think she's making a very big mistake.
I think she's being generous.
Well, generosity isn't always the best policy when you're dealing with a snake.
Nice dress.
Why, Lindsay, thank you. I think I'd look pretty hot in it myself.
Why, yes, yes, you do. But it's not going to do you any good. I just want you to take a look at something. Take a look out there. See that pretty little picture? You get used to it. Because that's pretty much the way it's going to be.
You know, I really haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about. So perhaps if you let me go, I can go.
Sorry.
You, Cassie, this is ridiculous. This is your wedding day, and, you know, obviously you're just very stressed.
Oh, thanks to you, I'm not feeling a thing.
You know, black humor is often a form of denial.
Denial? Barbara, I'm not in denial. I know exactly who killed Drew. Put me in this chair.
Excuse me, have either one of you seen Jessica?
No.
No.
Cassie?
Hmm.
Do you need my help?
No, thank you. No, Barbara's gonna make sure that everything is taken care of.
Okay. If you need anything, just call them, please.
Mm-hmm.
Where were we?
Jess! Jessica! 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 Jessica!
Well, what the hell is this? A Buchanan bachelor party without old Lisa?
Hey, somebody hand Paul a glass.
You got it.
We were looking for you. All
right. Where have you been hiding?
Fasten your seatbelts, Dorian. It's going to be a bumpy night.
Hey, Mel, get rid of the phone. Come here. Come here.
All right.
Come on.
I'm here. All right, what is this, Mel? What do you got?
Well?
Hi, boys. To our children. And to our future.
You're here,
brother.
Here.
Cheers.
Kevin, my boy, we have a hot news flash for you.
All right.
Straight off the press.
Buchanan sentenced to a lifetime of happiness. Give me this.
Give me this. Not so fast.
Oh, no.
Fellas have collaborated on a little story.
Aces begins.
Aces first.
That's right.
My grandson was always something of a maverick. I thought he'd be running wild forever. Until Cassie slipped a silken lasso around his neck.
Your next, Clint.
Okay. But Kevin wasn't just handed to me in some hospital corridor by a smiling nurse. No, I had to marry his mother to get him for a son. And man, did he give me grief for a while. Till I tamed him. Or he tamed me, I'm not sure which. All kidding aside, he's been one heck of a terrific son. Now he's won the hand of Cassie Carpenter, Mel's gorgeous stepdaughter, and one day he just might win the Pulitzer Prize.
Uh-oh.
Nice. Competition.
When I think of my nephew, I think of a pit bull.
Well, thanks, Uncle Bo. That's really kind of you.
When he grabs onto a lead, he doesn't let go. He's dogged, and he's doggone lucky.
Amen to that. Man. That's true.
I remember my first day in school.
Oh, boy.
Kevin left quite a legacy for me to live up to. And he also saved my butt quite a few times from that kid Tommy Tucker who tried to kick it across the schoolyard. No laughing. You know, you've always been there for me, bro. And I wish you the best. All the happiness in the world.
Thanks.
I know what I asked of you was very difficult, but I... There was no one else I could have trusted.
Hey. Nora, you have to understand, I would never interfere with this child, ever. I mean, this baby is yours and Beau's, period. And I just wish you all nothing but the best.
Thank you. I feel like I can really relax and enjoy what's coming. But I'll always be grateful, Sam.
Lindsay, have you seen Will or Jessica anywhere?
No, I haven't seen them for a while.
Look, they seem to have disappeared. And I was wondering if your son had said anything to you about leaving.
My son hasn't said anything to me about anything for a while.
I see. Okay, well, I can't find either of them anywhere, and frankly, I'm very concerned.
Well, as long as Will is with Jesse, I'm not concerned about them at all. I'm sure they'll be back before the ceremony.
Hi, come on in. I've got new guests, because I'm the flower girl. I'm the ringleader.
You're the ring bearer, not the ring leader. Say it, ring bearer.
Ring bearer.
Ring bearer, that's right.
Come on, let's go play.
Star Manning? You both are in this wedding, now don't get yourselves dirty.
We won't.
We won't.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Yeah, I'm sure you won't. How you doing?
Hi, Andrew. Nice to see you.
You're beautiful.
Thank you. You look mighty handsome yourself.
Thank you, Kelly.
How are you?
I'm glad you're here. I didn't know if you'd be comfortable, you know, seeing Cassie get married again.
Yeah, well, things we do for our children, Kelly. Anyway, I'd like to wish her my best. Do you know where she is?
Yeah, she's upstairs getting ready with her new best friend, Barbara Graham.
Kevin is waiting downstairs for a wedding to begin. Cassie, he loves you. You two are about to have a wonderful life together.
With him feeling pity every time he looks at me?
If you really believe that, then why are you marrying him?
Oh. You think you're the one who should be saying I do? Waiting for him in bed tonight? Or do you only like sex when it's behind my back?
What happened between Kevin and I is in the past. I am with Joey now.
Oh, really? So maybe I should warn him what a good shot you are.
You know, if you really believe that I'm responsible, why don't you just turn me in?
Because that'd be too easy. Why should you have it easy? I don't.
Okay, so then if I am such a murderess, you should be frightened.
Oh, honey, believe me, if anything happens, every PD in the country will get a letter saying what I know.
So then you're just gonna torture me.
Do you believe in karma? That what you do comes back at you with equal force? Pretty scary concept. I started having nightmares as soon as I found out you had slept with Kevin. And they have only gotten worse. I hear that gunshot every time my head hits the pillow. I am not going to dance at my wedding. And I will never go for a run in the park with my son.
I'm sorry.
So what do you think my attacker deserves? What do you think is going to balance those scales?
I don't know. I didn't do it.
Barbara! You take my advice. The next time you confess your sins in a church, you had better make sure it is really empty. Andrew may be sworn to silence, but I am not.
What's going on?
Barbara and I are just getting to know each other a little bit better.
You think that's wise?
Everyone has misjudged that girl. She's so much more than we all give her credit for.
Go ahead.
All right. He's not a big word. Lips.
An even bigger word.
Patent. It's overrated.
No, it's not. Go.
Kiss your lips and your neck and that funny thing connect your ear to your head.
Oh, I got one. Actually, you know, I'm not even sure this is a word.
Open your hand.
See, I don't really understand why Barbara's in the wedding party after everything that happened.
Aren't you the one who always preaches forgiveness?
Oh, well, sure I do, but it takes time and work and requires a higher power, not snap of a finger.
Okay. It's time for the father of the bride.
Hi, Daddy.
Here we go.
These two need some time alone.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. Excuse me for a moment, David. Cassie, wish you all the best. Always have.
Thank you.
You bet. See you downstairs.
Do you remember these? You gave them to Mother, right?
I remember.
I wish you were here. But at least you're here. I don't want you to get tired today, all right? Promise me that if you need to rest, you will.
I promise.
Where do you find the courage? I'm not as strong as you are.
You're stronger.
I'm not. Not in my heart. Lately, I have been filled with anger, rage, self-pity, these crazy impulses. I don't even know my own self anymore.
I understand.
I want to talk to you, okay? But not tonight, because it seems that there is a wedding tonight, and I thank you for not questioning this rush.
Your choice.
Yes, and it is too late to turn back.
It's never too late.
Mommy!
Look at you! Oh, my handsome little boy. Oh, I see you.
Machine Man.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Out of here. Out of here, guys. Place for the ladies. See ya, see ya, see ya. You got a wedding to get ready for. I'm sorry, Daddy. It is too late.
Well, it sounds like things are about to begin inside.
Let me just say that I hope that when this child gets married, you'll invite me to the wedding.
I'll even save you a dance.
Bought your ticket yet?
Issa, if you mean am I going to be on the next stage, no. You have to understand, I have nothing but respect for you and your family.
Nora, darling, you look wonderful. How do you feel?
Never better. I'm going for my first sonogram next week.
Easy, easy.
No, thanks. Any word on the election? Graham go down in flames? I hope he did.
Yeah, let's hope so.
So you haven't heard anything?
Is that cop still outside?
Yeah, I guess so. You don't really think Dorian would show up here, do you?
Well, she doesn't even know Cassie's getting married.
How would you know that?
Oh, excuse me, I gotta make a phone call, buddy.
No, late, pal. No, no, you gotta stick around and watch your protege walk down the aisle.
Barbara, this can't go on.
Please, Andrew, not now.
You know what you have to do now. Please, do it.
Hey, this conversation seems awfully serious. What's up?
Oh, you know, weddings. Kind of serious business. I'll talk to you later.
Take care.
Yeah. You okay? What are you guys talking about?
Oh, just, you know, being Cassie's bridesmaid. Barbara. I'm still a little uncomfortable. Come on, hold on a minute. It's time.
Go ahead.
The good news is that I'm not going to be the one up there doing the ceremony, okay? I'll talk to you later.
Hey, sir. Excuse me, have you seen my son?
No, I have not, and I can't find Jessica either.
Well, I saw the two of them together earlier. They were looking great, but, well, I got to be around here somewhere.
As soon as I get the signatures of the groom and the best man, we can begin.
Oh, excellent, Father. I tell you what, they are both right out there in the foyer, those two extremely handsome fellows.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Jessica, where are you?
Jessica, can you hear me? Look at me. Jessica.
Gonna catch on
fire. No, come on. Come on. Will. Okay.
Angel, you're the strongest one I've ever seen.
It's me, Roseanne.
And how many angels have you seen anymore?
So far.
No.
Joe, where's Jess? Where's Jess?
Christian's with her, okay? I mean, she's her brother. No, Alice.
Who's there? We need help. Run down to the road and flag someone down. Hurry.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered in the sight of God to witness the joining together in marriage of this man and this woman.
We can't do this. If we do this now, what about tomorrow? What about an hour from now? What about 10 minutes from now? What about all the people running around inside your head?
I don't know. Ask them.
It's too much. It's too soon. It's too risky for me as well as for you.
So now you want to go back, play the game? You should be more careful what you do with your toys, young lady. Something else.
Tom?
Yeah, because I don't really spell so good.
Wait, what's happening?
You know exactly what the hell is happening. You mind your manners, young man. I'll wash your mouth out with soap.
Cassie and Kevin have prepared their own vows, which they will share with us now.
You know, I wrote a bunch of stuff. And now that this moment is here, it just doesn't seem adequate. So I'm going to speak to you from my heart, and I'm just going to hope that I can find the words to truly explain to you how much you mean to me.
I think plain words would be just fine.
Okay. When I met you, I don't know, I just wasn't very centered. You know, my life was spinning off in a dozen different directions. You were like a lightning rod for me. You grabbed me, you put me back down on Earth. I need to see your face. I need to look into your eyes, because it's there where I see our future. When you smile, it's like this light shines around me. And I do, I get warm. And everything seems to make sense. And when I hear your voice, especially when you say my name, I feel alive. I love you. I love you very much. I'm always gonna love you. And I want you to be my wife.
Okay.
Okay.
When I fell in love with you, I was a different person. And I feel like so many things have changed. I've died and been reborn, and every time I open my eyes, there you are. You're my soulmate. What I want from you is simple. I want your life, and I want to give you mine. Till death do us part.
You got it.
Is there anyone present who objects to this union?
No, 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 you don't. We've come too far for you to blow this now.
By the power vested in me, I pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Thank you.
What is wrong with you?
You and Vicky. In a thousand years of hallowed history under this roof, I can't breathe. And then you're in there and you're arm in arm, and everyone is secretly wishing that you're going to get back together.
Our son just got married. Lindsay, Vicky will always be mother to my children. Honey, you are my wife.
Prove it.
What are you doing?
It's because everyone's celebrating in the other room. They're not going to miss us.
This is not the time or the place. This is Vicky's home. It wouldn't be right.
And you accuse me of not being over my ex?
Come on, Pete. Can't you just leave us alone? Don't you tell me what to do for the last time. You mind how you talk to that boy, young man? Up your nose with a rubber hose, Grandma.
All right, stop it. Let me talk to Rod.
Well, see? Oh, don't be frightened. Let me hold you. You really think I'm going to let some opera-loving guy who can't even talk right lay one finger on you for the last time? You mind how you talk to that young lady? He's horrible. He's just horrible.
Miss Perkins...
Why can't we just play a game, Pete? That's all. We were just trying to play a game. You shut up! God, I'm here. My head is all the time in the spinning. I don't feel so good.
The hell are you looking at? What? Where am I? Look at what Carlotta did. She went and outdid herself.
She's amazing. Just amazing. Barbara, do me a favor. Hand me the knife. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't be where I am. No, Barbara just was so helpful helping me getting ready for the wedding. Come here, honey.
Yeah.
Here we go. Someone's getting a tall piece. All right. All right, now you're taking responsibility.
Thanks so much.
Clint, I just found this note from Jessica.
She says she was upset about the breakup of Chris.
Right, and she didn't want to put a damper on the wedding. I mean, she says she's coming back later. But I have a really bad feeling about this, and I've had it all night.
Her name?
Buchanan. Jessica Buchanan.
Have a number for her parents?
Okay, ladies, gather around. Cash is gonna throw the bouquet.
Star, Renee.
Barbara.
What?
I really don't want to.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
I'm catching.
All right.
I'm catching.
Okay. Something's wrong. I mean, why does Cassie keep sitting down all the time? I have to see.
No, you don't. Look, just stay over here. Dorian, just stay right here.
Hey, I'm giving you an... Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3.
I got it.
All over you. Dorian, damn it!
Here. What are you doing? Sorry, Mother.
Please, sir, we gotta get her out of here. Come on, we gotta get her out.
Dorian, Lord
Hayden,
you're both under arrest.
Take your hands off my wife.
Right to remain silent. No. Choose to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be assigned you by the court. Do you understand your rights?
Love, honor, and cherish. The greatest wedding moments from All My Children, General Hospital, and One Life to Live. Available in bookstores from Hyperion.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next One Life to Live.
On the next One Life to Live.
Where's
Emma's? Please don't let her die.
It's all your fault. You did this to her.
You're going to get my mother out of this mess right now.
Todd? Todd, is that you?